Getting started with collection evaluation. This video provides an overview of the features and the interface to help you get started with collection evaluation. Collection evaluation provides quick, efficient access to information about your library collections, including comparisons to individual libraries, peer groups, and benchmark collections. Collection evaluation is designed to help staff make well-informed collection management decisions to facilitate efficient use of library space through data-driven deselection programs, to support new institutional programs and accreditation reviews, and to compare your library's resources to peer institutions. You can evaluate your collection in three different ways with collection evaluation. First, for deselection, use collection evaluation to make effective deselection decisions while still meeting the needs of users by identifying resources in high demand, as well as those that users can access from other libraries, and by spotlighting items that are unique to your library's collection. Second, for accreditation, use collection evaluation. You can determine how your collection supports an accreditation curriculum by examining the holdings of other libraries with similar programs. This will help in determining what resources you need to add to support your program and in determining whether your collection is up to date. And third, for acquisitions, use collection evaluation to compare your collection to authoritative and predefined lists, such as Choice, Booklist, and Library Journal, to determine which of these resources are held by your library and which of these resources are lacking, so that you can make informed decisions on acquisitions in a particular subject area to strengthen your collection. To log on to collection evaluation, enter the URL that you were given with your subscription. On the WorldShare login screen, enter the username that you were also given with your subscription. From this screen, you can also either set your password if this is your first time logging in, or reset your password. When you click on Set Reset Password, a new tab opens. To reset your password, enter your username and then click Request New Password. The system responds that you will receive an email with instructions for creating a new password. You should get an email right away from Library Password Management with the subject line Request to Manage Library Password. Use the link in this email to change your password. It's important to note that this link will expire within 24 hours, at which time you'll have to go through the password set reset process again. When you click on the link, this will take you to the Change Password screen. Your password will be case sensitive and must be 6 characters or more, with at least one non-alphabetic character. The characters semicolon, colon, apostrophe, and period are not allowed. Enter your username and new password. Then enter your new password a second time to confirm and then click Change Password. If both instances of your password match, the system responds, "Your password has been changed." If they do not match, you will need to re-enter and reconfirm your new password. Now you can go back to the WorldShare login screen, enter your username and password, and then click Sign In. After logging in to WMS Staff Interface, select Analytics from the horizontal navigation bar at the top of the screen to get started with collection evaluation. Then select Collection Evaluation from the left-hand menu to expand the Collection Evaluation panel. You'll see the My Library, My Comparisons, and Manage Comparisons tabs if your login has the admin role privileges assigned, which grants full user privileges for collection evaluation. If you're using a login without full privileges, you will only see the My Library tab. You'll still be able to analyze your holdings based on the OCLC subject conspectus, but you won't be able to view, filter, and export comparisons, create new comparisons, or manage your comparisons. First, let's take a look at the My Library screen. From here, you can view an analysis of your holdings in WorldCat based on the OCLC subject conspectus. You can see my total holdings are 357,306. You can view your total holdings also by publication date by default or by format. You can also limit your total holdings summary by publication date, latest circulation date, circulated number of times in lifetime, that's the number of times the item has circulated in its lifetime, format, language, and location. Your total holdings summary table can be exported as an Excel file. You can also export a list that includes title information about your holdings. This list will be available within 2 hours after you request it. Now let's take a look at the My Comparisons screen. If this is the first time you're logging in to Collection Evaluation, this screen will be blank. But once you've created a comparison, you can view a list of your active comparisons, open the benchmarking and unique share title screens, and export a comparison title list from this screen. You can hover over the information icon on any of the comparisons to view a summary of the comparison. The summary will include the last updated date, the expiration date, and the institutions included in the comparison. Now let's take a look at the comparison types for one of my active comparisons, NYU. Benchmarking provides insight into the strengths and gaps of your collection against the collections of the selected comparisons. A benchmark comparison indicates the titles that are unique to your collection, the titles you share with other collections in the comparison, and the titles that the comparison group owns but are not part of your collection. Benchmarking can be used as part of an accreditation process, evaluating resources when planning for a new academic program, or for acquisition candidates when using an authoritative source. You can select all subjects or specific subjects for your benchmarking comparison. For example, I'll choose anthropology. And then I click the right arrow to include anthropology. And then I would click on Create Chart. After the screen refreshes, I can save the image or I can view the data. I can also export a title list for my only holdings, holdings that are held by all in the comparison, or holdings that I don't have. I can preview the export, and then I can click on Export the Title List. The next type of comparison I can look at is the Unique Shared Title List. Unique Shared Title Lists are used for weeding and retention activities. When you create a unique shared title list, you're creating filters that refine the results of your comparisons. The unique shared title list can reflect the titles that are unique to your collection, only titles that are shared with the comparison group, or both. you can create a unique shared title list for all comparisons. After you create the unique shared title list, you can export the unique shared title list that shows the comparison with the filters applied to it. Again, you can select all available subjects or just choose specific subjects. You can apply the limits there you see on the left. Then you would click on Create Chart. After that, you can export the list. You can download it and do further analysis also with the shared or unique titles. Also on the My Comparisons tab is the Comparison Title List. The Comparison Title List is a system-generated spreadsheet containing the title-level collection data from the most recent version of the comparison you've built. It lists all of the titles that are in your library and the comparison institution. You'll need to assign a name to the exported reports file and optionally a brief description. Then click on OK. If your name does not meet the requirements for the export file, you'll have to click OK and re-enter a name for your comparison title list. Then click OK again. The system responds, "A My Comparisons export has been requested using the files you provided. It will be available in your My Files repository in approximately 2 hours. After 2 hours, you will be able to download the spreadsheet and keep it for your records. You can see I have just 3 active comparisons on the My Comparisons screen, but you can have up to 25 active comparisons at a time. Now let's take a look at the Manage Comparisons screen. From here, you can create new comparisons and manage your existing comparisons. To create a new comparison, you'll need to first select a comparison type. You can create a peer comparison, a comparison with a predefined group, such as the top 10 law school libraries, a comparison with an authoritative list, for example, Publishers Weekly, a comparison with the HathiTrust, or a comparison with all WorldCat institutions. These comparisons will be covered in detail in separate tutorials. Next, you'll need to give your comparison a unique name. Select the peer libraries that you'd like to use or choose from the available predefined authoritative or authoritative lists, and then you would click on Create Comparison to create your comparison. One-to-one peer, predefined group, authoritative lists, HathiTrust, and WorldCat comparisons are available immediately. One-to-many peer comparisons are pending for 24 hours after you create them. After 24 hours, the status will change to active and they'll be available for filtering and exporting on the My Comparisons tab. The list of current comparisons further down on this screen shows the comparison name, the last updated date, the expiration date, and the status for all comparisons. Each of these columns can be sorted. You can hover over the information icon to view the institutions in a comparison. Active comparisons expire 30 days after their last use. You can extend the life of an active comparison or reactivate an expired comparison in the Action column. The Actions column can also be used to deactivate an active comparison or to remove a comparison. Comparisons remain in the current comparisons table until they are removed by a user. If you run a comparison that you're not likely to go back to and to use anytime soon, you can remove it by clicking on Remove in the Action column. So I'll remove the Public Libraries comparison. I have to confirm you're deleting public libraries, and I'll click on Delete. System confirms your comparison public libraries has been deleted. If you don't want a comparison to expire, you can extend the expiration date to 30 days from the current date or simply use the comparison to reset the expiration date. For example, my WorldCat comparison is set to expire 10/24, which is tomorrow, so I can click on Extend. And the system responds you're extending the expiration date of WorldCat to 11/21/15. I'll click on Extend to confirm that. And the system confirms it has been extended. If a comparison is not used for 30 days, the comparison expires. And if you want to use it again, you must reactivate the expired comparisons. You can view the date that the comparison expired in the expiration date column. You must be an administrator to reactivate a comparison. For example, I'm going to reactivate the Brooklyn Public Library comparison, which expired 7/12/15. Again, I have to confirm that I am reactivating. I'll click Reactivate, and the system responds, my comparison Brooklyn Public Library has been reactivated. To access collection evaluation online help, click the Need Help link at the top, then click General Help. And then from here, click on Collection Evaluation to launch the online help system. If you have additional questions about getting started with collection evaluation, you can contact OCLC support in your region at oc.lc/support.